I didn't. Randy's side.
See you Monday.
Take care.
Good night now.
What are you doing?
I heard the news. You're getting married. Congratulations.
Put the gun down.
How could you do this?
You knew it wasn't going to work with us. We talked about it.
You never really gave it a chance, Ellen.
Robert, put the gun down. We agreed to be friends.
I got friends, Ellen! I got friends.
Robert, no.
What? It's okay. It's okay.
I can't put it behind me. I thought after 8 years.
Miami is something we're always gonna have to live with. Can't change that.
I want it to be over.
I know. I know. Come here, baby. I know.
Daddy, do they all read your resumes?
Well, I think so.
I hope so.
They'd better.
Mommy's dressed up again.
Yes, she has another job interview.
Why don't you and Mommy get jobs together?
Come on, hurry up. You're going to be late. Do you want me to mail this?
Yeah, would you please?
Yep. What are you doing today?
I'm just going to finish up here and get back on the phone. Good luck.
Thanks. Hurry up, you're gonna be late.
Okay. Bye-bye, sweetie. Have
fun. Bye, Dad.
Ellen Bradford?
Yes.
Hi, I'm Lester Holland. I'll be right with you.
Okay, thanks.
Oh, hello, Mr. Holland. I have some messages for you.
I'm running a little late. I just need 5 minutes.
I'll be back in a minute. Are you all right?
Yeah. You know, they push you, and they push you, and they push you, and it's never about how I'm feeling or if I'm having a bad day. It's only about the bottom line here.
It always is.
My father was right. You know what he said? He said that you have to be a shark to survive in this business. that you have to be able to smell the blood.
I think you just have to be able to smell the money and be really good at what you do.
I am really good at what I do. That's the problem. I'm so good at it that they won't let me move up. They'd rather keep me in my cage. Only I'm finally up for a promotion, director of sales administration.
Good luck.
Thanks. Who's your broker here?
Me. I hope. I'm interviewing in about 2 minutes.
Oh, my gosh. You're Ellen Bradford. Deirdre Bosnell. I saw your resume.
Nice meeting you.
You haven't worked in 9 years, huh?
No. I left my job in New York and moved out here with my husband, and I've been a full-time mom since then.
What's he do?
He got laid off 6 months ago, so one of us has got to work.
Hey, can I give you some free advice? Play up everything you know about the overseas market. Les will love you for it.
Thanks.
Also, he's a sailing nut. He takes his 40-foot catch out every weekend.
Are you always so well informed?
Yeah. Well, after 5 years here, I know everything.
Well, nice meeting you.
Yeah, you too.
So, what makes a woman give up on such a promising career on Wall Street and just drop off for so long?
My husband is an aircraft engineer, and he was transferred to California, and we wanted to start a family.
You like it?
Oh, very much so. The weather's great for sailing.
Oh, you sail?
Mm-hmm.
Me too.
Oh, really?
I could spend all day out on the water. I spoke to Miles Berwitz at Powers Morehouse in New York. He had some very nice things to say about you, but he thought that you took a job at another firm, but I don't see it here.
Well, as I told you, after I got married, we relocated to the Los Angeles area. Mr. Howland, I was handling over $60 million in funds for my clients when I was at Powers Morehouse, most of that in offshore accounts.
I should tell you that there is one other person that we're considering.
Ellen? How did it go?
Oh, it went fine. I mean, it's exactly what I'm looking for, but I think he's interested in someone else.
Oh. Oh, it's that Harvard guy, Richard something. He's trying to steal him from another firm. Well, let me see what strings I can pull.
Pull him hard.
I will. I like you. Ellen, thanks for listening to my garbage back there.
Oh, don't mention it.
Nobody else has time. Richard Josephson, hello. Richard Josephson? Hi, it's Marcia from Lester Howland's office. Yes, Lester had to fly to London on business, but he wanted me to let you know that the position has been filled. Yes. No, I'm sorry, I don't know any of the details. Yes, we will get in touch with you if something else comes up. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yes, bye. Ready?
Mm-hmm. Oh, great. I'll tell you something. If you do wind up replacing me, you're going to have a tough time finding a secretary as good as you are.
Have you heard anything yet?
Not yet.
Ted said I was at the top of a very short list.
We should know soon.
Mr. Howland will be very disappointed when he hears you turn down the job.
What's that one?
3560.
No.
Sherry Grayson said her parents got divorced because they ran out of money.
Don't worry, honey. That's not going to happen to us.
I hope not.
Ellen, let me introduce you to everyone.
Okay. Dana, this is Ellen Bradford.
Hi, Dana.
Tony over here. That's John.
Yeah. Could you sign this one,
please? Yeah, sure. Oh, Mary, this is our newest broker, Ellen Bradford.
Hi, Mary. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
My pleasure.
Hi. Welcome to the rat race.
Hi, Deidre.
Congratulations.
Thanks. I'll talk to you later.
Has it been late before? Have I ever had them late before?
All right, it's right down here.
Okay.
You'll get the check. Erin! I can't help that!
That's Ted. Let's get you settled in here.
Thanks.
Here you are. You're gonna do great. I'm counting on you.
Thanks, Lance. Hello? In his office now? I'll be right there.
So, Deidre, you've been here for 5 years now, and we just couldn't ask for anything more. In fact, you're the best secretary in the whole company. I don't want you to take this as a setback, but Mary's job requires the kind of expertise at interpersonal relationships that I'm just not sure you've acquired yet. Now, please don't be upset, because there will be other opportunities, I promise you. In the meantime, I cannot express enough.
You never said anything, did you?
Look, Les is a busy man.
Guess who just got busy tomorrow night?
See the mountains out the window?
No, I don't know how many clients I have yet. Yeah, but I got a, you know, big new office, and there's a window and view and expenses. Yeah, they said that I might be traveling.
Oh, things are turning around. You'll be next.
Yeah. Your big raise, commission, so you can stop worrying about the mortgage, Daddy.
I love you, too.
Could you file these when you get a chance?
Sure. Filing's my specialty.
Hi, it's for Mary. I heard the news. I'm sure you'll get the next one.
Ellen, do you, would you go to lunch with me today?
Oh, I have so much work already.
It's okay.
But I'd love to do it another day.
Hello. Data Aerospace?
Mm-hmm.
Can I have human resources, please? Hello. My name is Marcia Hastings, and I work for a firm in Los Angeles, and we just hired a man who listed your company as a previous employer, and I'd like to verify that he worked there. Yes. Eric Bradford. Mm-hmm. Yes, I can hold. Ellen, are you hiding something from me? Yes? How long? He left 7 years ago. No, that's just... That's what I needed to know. Yes, thank you. Okay. So you lived in Miami 7 years ago. You didn't come here from New York. Why did you tell me you came here from New York? Huh. Oh, that's interesting. You were a broker in Miami. Why didn't you want me to know that? Yes, in Miami. Could you give me the number of Keller Huntington?
Yes, this is Marcia Hastings from Millennium Investments in Los Angeles. Yeah. I'm doing a reference check on an Ellen Bradford.
Ellen Bradford? Well, she left Huntington in August 1988.
Really? She didn't list the job on her resume, and we were wondering if there was any reason why.
Well, have you hired her already?
We're about to.
You don't know anything about what happened?
No.
Well, Ellen was involved with a broker she worked with here. When she told him she was going to marry some other guy, he couldn't take it. Wound up killing himself in her office. It was all over the papers. Had everyone talking. Anyway, she left the company.
Thank you.
Hello?
Ted didn't tell me he had a new neighbor.
And you are?
George Mathias.
Ellen Bradford.
Very nice to meet you, Ellen Bradford.
Nice to meet you. Are you a client of Ted's?
Depends.
It depends on how rich we can make him.
Ted, I'm already rich. I just want to be happy.
Well, let's see what we can do about that, huh?
Nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you.
Can I talk to you a second?
Sure.
I've been working on Mathias for about 3 months now. I'm not gonna lose him to someone who's been here for 2 days.
Ted, I was hardly trying to steal your business. Oh, man, I gotta pick up my daughter. I'm never gonna get this finished.
Hey, is that for the staff meeting?
Yeah, first thing in the morning.
Well, give it to me. I'll do it.
Really?
Yeah, go get your daughter. I'll leave it on the desk in the morning.
Gee, thanks. Yeah. Very nice of you to help her like that.
I am very nice.
Deirdre, call in line 2.
Hello? Hi, Daddy. A merger? Really? Yeah, I'll call you later.
Okay.
Slow down.
Hi.
Hi.
Is this Ellen Bradford's house?
Yes, it is.
I need to give her something.
Well, I can take it.
And who are you?
I'm Cindy. Who are you?
Deirdre. Hi. Hi.
Oh, my report. You didn't have to do that. Thank you.
I thought you might want to review it tonight.
That's very sweet of you.
No big deal. I'm gonna get going.
Do you want to join us for some dinner?
Are you sure?
Well, yeah.
You, if you're willing to take a risk on my cooking, yeah.
Yeah, I loved you. I loved you.
Come on. I'm Eric.
Hi, Deidre. If you want to get ahead in this business, you have to be able to anticipate trends. That's what my father always says.
Is your father in the business?
Oh, yeah. He was the most brilliant trader, thank you, of offshore funds you've ever seen. The master of Lloyd and McKellen, they used to call him. Until he got screwed by the SEC. They took away his license and everything. Nearly destroyed the poor guy.
What happened to him?
He tried to kill himself, and he ended up in a wheelchair, and now he lives in some home. Anyway, you know that guy, George Mathias, that you met?
Mm-hmm.
Les would sell his mother into slavery for that account. He's got millions. And I thought your presentation looked really good, but...
You looked through my report?
I hope you're not mad at me. It was great, especially the Rickenheim lead, but I've been doing some research myself, and I have something I think will blow you away.
Really?
Now, to the newest member of the firm, I believe you all know Ellen Bradford.
Hi.
Ah, Mr. Burke. A privilege as always. Go ahead, Ellen.
Yeah. I've been looking at Rickenheim, which is a leading exporter of earth-moving equipment. And the governments of emerging Asian countries are really putting hundreds of millions of dollars into their urban infrastructure. The interesting part is that Rickenheim's about to merge with a Taiwanese cement company. They'll have over 80% of the market.
Get us a full analysis.
Absolutely.
Ted, if this pans out, I think George Mathias ought to be the first one to know about it. Work with Ellen. That's not bad. You got anything else?
Yeah, following up on a tip from Deidre, I have information on a planned merger in the railroad industry that I'm currently tracking.
Deidre, my ass. The tip came from Chuck.
Who's Chuck?
Her father.
Tell us more about it.
Well, as you know, the railroad industry has experienced some difficulties in the 80s and the 90s. But now they're currently turning that around, and they're really growing at quite a rapid pace. This merger will create major financial opportunities.
Marcia, line two.
She's not here right now, but if it's important, I'd go find her.
Someone wants to know if Les is back from London.
I know what this is about. I'll take it. Hello? Mr. Josephson, how are you? Yes, he is back, but he's tied up. Before you speak to him, there's something I need to talk to you about. It's very confidential. Yeah, I can't really speak here. I really want to thank you for meeting me out here.
Yeah, well, tell me what this is all about, please.
I don't know how to say this. The woman who got the job you interviewed for lied her way into the position.
So?
Well, what I mean to say is that she fed Les a bunch of phony connections and references, and he bought into her. But she's terrible, and everybody hates her. So, if you just waited a month or so, she'll be gone, and I promise I'll get you into that position.
Look, I appreciate what you're trying to tell me. I told Lester I was going to check in with him. You said I was the leading
candidate.
That's
a really bad idea. I've been keeping an eye on Les for the last couple of weeks.
Wait a minute. I thought he was in London.
Yeah. Before that.
What did he tell you about my second interview?
He said it was fine. That's not the problem.
I never had a second interview, okay? You're lying to me, and I don't like the game you're playing, okay? I don't like it at all.
Where are you going? Wait, you can't call him. No, you can't. You can't.
Get the damn hands off.
You can't do this to me.
Crazy.
You can't do this to me.
Coming, Daddy!
Come on.
was that today?
I don't remember exactly.
Dee Dee, what kind of broker do you expect to be if you can't remember such things?
You're right.
You got responsibilities.
I could make a bloody fortune if I could only trade that stock.
What's wrong with you? Look, aren't you interested?
I give up.
Daddy? Daddy? I am interested. Okay? My promotion was just the beginning. You'll see. You heard about Richard Josephson?
Yeah.
It's pretty awful, huh?
Oh, pretty strange. I mean, he could have been here instead of me. Everything would have been different.
But don't you think everything happens for a reason? Hey, have you met all the people here, the execs and their clients?
Well, I can't say I've met all of them.
Well, tonight's a really great night for networking. I'll introduce you around.
Wednesday night is power night. Everybody just kind of hangs out. What do you want to drink?
Glass white wine.
Well, look who decided to mingle with the masses. You should go say hi.
He's not my client, Deidre.
Yeah, but he's not Ted's either, yet.
Is that why you brought me here?
I'm just looking out for my friends. Come on.
How's it going, Jimmy? Give me a scotch and a white.
White ones. Oh,
Mary, and you? Listen, stay here.
Ellen Bradford.
My nuts and bolts, man. Maybe two should meet each other. Really? What the hell do you think you're doing?
Oh, come on, Ted. We just wanted to say hello.
Did anything I say to you sink in?
Ted, really, I have no...
You are crossing over the line, lady.
Please.
Look, let me tell you something. You try to take business away from me, it'll be the last good day you ever have. You understand me? You understand me?
Let go of my arm. Bye, Deidre.
Ted, let it go, let it go.
Can you please just mind your goddamn housewife, for Christ's sake?
Hey. I need to talk to you. Do you, you think we can go to the office?
Sell stocks like you fuck. Less would make you vice president tomorrow.
Maybe you would have run out of all your promises. I've been so full of crap.
Give me a break, huh? I'm not the boss around here.
Maybe I've been sleeping with the wrong guy, huh? What are you gonna do about George Mathias?
What am I gonna do about him? $60 million is mine.
Please, you're a bond specialist. 60% of George's business is in the offshore market, which you know jack shit about.
Is there anything that goes on in this office that you don't know about?
I know that Ellen is an expert in offshore accounts.
close to her.
It's just your ego talking. I've been watching you work. Staring at the computer every night, all night. Coming in hungover. Hoping your clients don't notice, the ones who haven't left you yet. You're gonna lose the account, split it with her. At least you'll be able to share in some of the glory, if not the commission.
Since when are you so concerned about me?
Because then maybe one or both of you can finally convince Lester that my talents are being wasted as a secretary.
I'll convince him. Just give me a little time.
Ted completely misunderstood. Next thing I know, everyone in the bar is staring at us.
Listen, this is all just starting to sound a little familiar.
Meaning?
Meaning, when I think of why we had to leave Miami, giving up a job I liked, uprooting our lives, I just don't want to see that happen again, okay?
And you think Robert is happening all over again?
Well, this guy, Ted, sounds like he's about as unstable as Robert was. Men like that will do anything to get to you. Listen, you want my opinion, don't work with him. Simple as that.
Daddy, how would you feel if I told you that one day you'd be on top again?
How's that?
Getting rich for real, not just playing around with that computer.
That was a long time ago, baby. Just get me that pillow.
I've been working on something, Daddy. Something that'll make you very proud of me.
What is it?
Well, I've been watching the overseas market, just like you said. And there's going to be a merger between a company called Rickenheim and a Taiwan firm. And I am going to make a commission on it that you wouldn't believe. And then we could put everything behind us. And we could start a new life somewhere where you can do just what you do best, make money.
What are you talking about, Dee Dee? You just got a promotion.
Look, Daddy,
our life is here.
Daddy, trust me.
Good morning, Alan.
Morning.
Ted has graciously offered to team up with you to land this Matthias account. Now, given your respective talents, I think it's a brilliant idea.
I don't think it's such a good idea.
Why not? Is there some problem?
No.
Good. Because George Matthias will be here in 2 days, and he wants a full presentation. No time to waste. Any questions?
No.
I'll be out of the office till 4:30 with meetings. We can start then.
Hmm? Wonderful. Hi, it's me. I'm going to be a little late tonight.
What time do you think you'll be home?
Not too late, 8 or 9, I think. At Les asked Ted and me to work on the Matthias presentation.
I thought we understood each other on this subject.
Eric, it's my job. It's also a shot at a big commission, and God knows we need the money.
Good. Well, then I'll just see you when I see you, right?
Eric, come on. I don't have a choice.
Yes, you do.
Would you try to understand, okay? I love you.
Me too. Be careful.
Bye.
Thank you.
It always happens. It'll go off in a minute.
Everybody out, there's a fire in the back. I called the fire department.
How long is that gonna take?
Don't know yet.
So what is that?
They gotta check the rest of the building. I mean, this could take all night.
Well, maybe we should, work on this first thing in the morning.
I can't. I got a breakfast meeting with a client. I got meetings all day long.
Well,
I got all the data at home on the computer. We can go back there and work.
At your house?
Yeah, why not?
No reason.
Yeah?
Yeah, but I can only do it for a few hours.
Tonight?
All right. Where do I go?
Follow me. You sure you want to stop?
Yeah, we can work on the overseas portfolio tomorrow. I gotta get going.
I gotta tell you, you know your stuff.
Thanks.
I didn't even offer you anything to eat. Are you hungry?
No, I'm fine.
I got some leftover Chinese food in there from last night. It's really good.
Oh, that's
I can
really
eat
great.
It up.
No, listen. I gotta go home.
Ellen. Yeah. Look, I'm sorry about the other night.
It's okay.
No, I was out of line.
Don't worry about it. We did good work tonight.
You did, didn't you? Ellen. Look, I can't talk now. I said I can't talk now. Harry, look, I'm not going to go over this now. I called him 3 times today.
Ted.
How did you get in here?
Do you remember these clothes?
Remember what?
You should remember them. You took them off me the first time we did it. Why do guys have such lousy memories? I had a surprise for you.
Yeah, what is it?
Close your eyes.
Come
on, close your eyes.
What is it?
Close your eyes.
They're closed.
You sure?
Yeah.
Real tight? No more late nights at the office, Ted. Your career was over anyway.
What's his name?
Ted.
Ted, yeah.
Fine. No problems. We got a lot of work done. Good. I wanted to...
Daddy?
Coming, honey.
Marcia, what happened? Ted killed himself. What? The housekeeper found him this morning. Shot himself in the head. Calm down. Calm down. Hey. So what happened last night?
We went to work at his house. He was fine when I left.
Ellen, does anyone else know you were there?
No.
Your husband?
I didn't tell him.
It's our secret.
Yeah, it won't be once I tell the police.
Nick, do you think that's a good idea? Ellen, I know what happened in Miami. I know about Robert.
What?
It's part of my job. I like to think I'm good at what I do.
Well, who else knows?
Nobody. I'm your friend. Ellen, I wouldn't tell anybody.
Teacher, you have to understand what happened. Robert killed himself because he couldn't have me. He's held me prisoner for years. Do you have any idea what it is to be trapped?
Yes.
Everyone wondered what happened. Some people thought I was responsible. I had to resign. I tried to get another job, but the business community shut me out. So Eric and I moved out here to start over. Look what happened.
What happened? You didn't kill Ted, did you?
No, of course not.
That's my point. It was a suicide. Why tell them anything they don't need to know?
How can I not tell them?
Ellen, think of the consequences. If you're a suspect, they're gonna find out about Robert. They're gonna wonder how that could happen twice. You can't take that chance.
So when was the last time you saw Ted?
Yesterday, Detective.
What kind of mood was he in?
He seemed fine, in good spirits. We were working together until the building was evacuated. There was a fire in the back.
Then you went home?
Yes.
Now, I understand that you and Ted didn't get along very well.
We had our differences. I know he wasn't a happy person.
So you think he might have had a reason to take his own life?
I don't know. I didn't know him that well.
Of course. All right. Thank you. Is that your daughter?
Yes.
You're very pretty.
Thank you.
Something?
Oh, I can't seem to find my leather portfolio.
Are you all right?
I don't know. It just all seems so unreal.
I just don't get it. When Ted works his butt off last night on this Matthias presentation, and then he leaves a note on the computer and shoots himself.
He left a note?
Yeah. Said, I can't stand life anymore. Anyway, there is still this presentation to finish. And it looks like it's gonna fall on your shoulders. Can you handle it?
Yes.
That one. Good, that one. And this one. And this one. Hi.
Hi.
Hey, sweetie. How are you doing?
Hey, look at the puzzle we're doing.
Oh, that's beautiful. Mm-hmm. Why don't you go start your bath?
Okay, are you coming?
I'll be there in a second.
All right.
You look beat.
What's that?
Ted Burke killed himself. He was stressed, overworked. Someone should have seen this coming. I'm coming, sweetie.
Was he okay when you two left the office last night?
Mommy, Daddy?
I suppose so. I better go.
Hi, Ellen. I hear you get to lend the Matthias account.
Yeah, only if he likes the portfolio I'm preparing for him.
Oh, that's great. I know you'll do it. Hey, what do you say we go get lunch? It'll give us a chance to talk.
Oh, thanks, but I brought mine.
That's okay. I'll pick up a sandwich and we can eat outside, okay?
I just wanted to thank you again for not saying anything.
About what?
About what you found out.
Don't be silly, Ellen. After all the trouble I went through to get you your job, why would I want to see you lose it?
I wouldn't say you got me my job, Deidre.
Oh, I would. Do you think they were going to hire you? I fixed things. If it wasn't for me, you'd be out pounding the pavement, wondering how to feed your family.
Let's not get carried away. I mean, you may have helped me, but...
Ellen, listen to me. It was all me.
What was all you?
I got you noticed by Les. It was my idea to put you and Ted on the Matthias campaign. You followed me wherever I led you. Because in the end, it's about one thing there, the bottom line. And you're no different than anybody else. My father always says, nobody gets a free ride, and that includes you.
What are you talking about?
I'm getting out of my cage. And I need money. I need you to help me get it.
You are out of your mind.
What are the police gonna think when they find out you were at Ted's last night?
What?
I'm the only one that knows you were at his house. Maybe you got away with murder once, but twice?
You stay away from me.
What about Les and your husband? What if they found out?
Get away from me.
It's okay, she works for me. She works for me now.
Did you invite someone for dinner?
Yeah.
Dinner's ready.
She was in the neighborhood.
So sad what happened to Ted. Pressure must have really got to him. Spaghetti coming in for a landing. Does it make you feel weird that you may have been the last person to see him that night?
Coming in for landing.
Stop it.
Ellen, she's just playing.
She's not going to eat her food. She shouldn't play with it.
Where are you going?
I'm not hungry.
I wonder if the police are going to find anything suspicious.
I thought it was a suicide.
That was really yummy, son. And thanks again for dinner. Our problems?
Ah, yes, that's my project for tomorrow.
afternoon. Go put Cindy to bed. Good night.
I'll walk you to your car.
Bye, Eric. He's a really great guy. I think you're lucky.
You fucking bitch.
Shh. Helen, you don't want people to hear you.
You stay away from my family or I swear to God, I'll kill you.
I think your family likes me.
What the hell do you want?
I already told you, money. Pretty soon, I'm gonna need a small favor. Just a little transfer of funds to an offshore account. It's your specialty. And then I'll be able to destroy the other copy of that tape.
Your blackmail fantasy is pretty pathetic, Deidre. I'm sure the police would be fascinated to hear it.
I think they'd be much more fascinated to see your folder. Have you seen it lately? It's a mess. All that nice leather caked in dried blood. It'd be a real shame if the police got a hold of it. Whose blood you suppose they'll find? Not to mention Ted's coffee cup, the one with your fingerprints on it.
You were there? You killed him.
No, you did.
What?
That's how it's gonna look. And if you insist on going to the police, well, I'm gonna have to come forward, and I would hate to have to put you through that again. The accusations, the humiliation, the denial that no one is gonna believe. You'll lose your family, you'll lose your career, maybe 20 years of your life, because no one will believe you. There's no one you can talk to, Ellen. No one but me. Do what I tell you, and no one will ever know.
You will never get away with this.
The monthly financial statements go out tomorrow. Your clients won't get their next statement for another 30 days. That leaves you 30 days to cover whatever you do. Now, I'd suggest running away. I mean, you've done it before. I'd say you have talent for it. I like you, Ellen. That's why I'm freeing you. Before this company chews you up and spits you out, just like they do to everybody.
Oh, have fun today, sweetie.
Bye, Daddy.
Bye-bye. Hey, are you sure there isn't anything you want to talk about?
I gotta go. Let's go.
I hope you've made the right decision.
And not like you, Deidre. I don't steal other people's money.
Everybody has their price. I'm going to lunch.
It's not even noon yet. I want to talk to you.
The global funds, these allow you to set up different European and Asian-based accounts to take advantage of the rise of the dollar against world currencies. I'd like to suggest the following. That leaves us with the remaining $2 million. We need to talk about offshore tax shelters for a moment.
Paper Tommy Daniels is up and working the bullpen. Dale Clark's on his way to the mound. I have a picture here.
What about high yield securities?
Oh, absolutely a part of our basic
foundation. Yeah, Clark signal to right field. That's the signal.
All right, I'm sold. Who gets the check?
Welcome aboard.
Excuse me. Ellen, you have a phone call. I think it's important. Line one.
Thank you.
I'll be a moment. Hello?
Who
Oh, my God. How badly? Oh, what about my daughter? She is. Thank you. Excuse me.
Next time you might not be so lucky. That was one long lunch, Deirdre. Sorry, a friend had car trouble.
Excuse me?
How can I let this happen? Oh, where's Cindy?
She's at the Graysons.
Good.
Eric, this wasn't an accident.
What are you talking about?
It was Deirdre. I don't know how, but she did this to you.
Deirdre?
Eric, somehow she found out about Miami. And she was there when Ted died. She killed him.
Killed Ted? Why?
To frame me.
What does she want from you?
She wants me to embezzle money for her.
Well, how could she frame you if you weren't even there?
Because I was.
What were you doing at his house?
There was a fire in the office, and we went back to his house to use the computer so we could finish the presentation. He was fine when I left him. She obviously came after that.
This is unbelievable. Well, you're gonna have to go to the police.
I can't. I don't have any proof that she did this, and she's fabricated evidence against me already. I've already lied to the police.
What did you say to them?
I didn't tell them I was there. I mean, she set the perfect trap, and I walked right into it. They're gonna think I killed Ted.
And why did she do this to me?
So that I'd do exactly what she wanted.
Oh, where is this ever gonna end for us, Ellen?
I'm sorry. I thought I could handle this myself. I was wrong not to come to you. She's playing on her fears that what happened to us before will happen again.
Well, if you don't trust me enough to tell me things, she won't have to.
Eric, I said I was wrong. I could walk right out that door and not come back. I don't want to.
Well, if you can't go to the police, we're gonna have to figure something out. There must be a way.
I am not going to let her destroy.
Six. Here. Alone. And please don't think of trying anything funny.
I have files that have to be reviewed before you leave tomorrow. Hello, Ellen.
Hi, Mary. Going somewhere?
Chicago. My grandmother's sick.
Really? Would you come in here, please?
Mary's office. It's always urgent whenever Daddy calls. He's a pretty big influence in her life, isn't he?
Oh, that's an understatement.
It must be hard going from who he was to being in a nursing home.
Beats prison. That's where some of his friends wound up.
Really? Like who?
Like his right-hand man, James Robinson. Got Chuck into a lot of trouble. Now he's in some club fed in San Bernardino. See ya.
Yes, James Robinson. It's very important that I talk to him. Can you tell me when visiting hours are?
Well, to what do I owe the pleasure?
I'm Ellen Bradford. I'm trying to find Chuck Bosnell. He's supposed to be in a nursing home, but I have no idea where.
Why are you so interested?
I work with his daughter, Deirdre.
So why don't you ask her?
Well, she's been having some problems at the office lately, and I want to help her.
So she talks about her father often. I thought if I spoke with him, I could...
I can understand. That relationship's always been bizarre. Chuck wouldn't let his kid more than 10 feet out of his sight. And she's just as dependent, especially since he went into the wheelchair.
When he tried to kill himself.
Kill himself? Chuck, he fell down the stairs.
But Deidre said he tried to kill himself.
That's ridiculous. She was there when it happened.
She was.
One of the neighbors said he could hear them screaming at each other all the way down the block.
Do you have any idea where he is now?
And you ask me? Chucky never let her put him in a nursing home. He'd rather be dead.
Okay, Mrs. Miller, you're confirmed on flight 115 from L.A. to Mexico City at 9 p.m. Friday. Enjoy your trip.
Flight 7 from Mexico City to Taipei with connection to Manila leaves 6 a.m. Saturday. I'm confused, Miss Smith. There's a much easier way to get you to the Philippines.
I like flying.
You're all set up, Miss Miller. When you arrive in Manila, just present your personal identification code and your account number.
How soon will funds be made available to me after I make the transfer?
Immediately, Miss Miller.
Thanks. Listen, I'll be wiring $6 million into your bank. Mm-hmm. Yes, tomorrow night, via electronic transfer. The account number is 24673222. And the funds will be wired from an LA firm called Millennium Investments. And why 48 hours? I was told 24. Mm-hmm. By my broker, Bradford. Ellen Bradford. For now.
Hi, you've reached the Bradfords. Please leave a message.
It's Marsha. Please call me as soon as you get in.
It's about Deidre. Please call me at home. My number is 555-4306.
Did you need me?
No.
Mistake. Do you always listen in on other people's phone conversations?
I wasn't listening to you.
Really? I suppose that wasn't Ellen you just tried to call either.
That's my business.
Ellen and I are working on something together. Do you have a problem with that?
Should I? Excuse me, I'm going to be late for my class.
So what did you find out?
I think I know how to get to her.
How?
Her father. Deidre lied to us. Her father's not in a nursing home. I think he's living with her.
What do you think he's in on it?
I don't know. But I've got to go to her house. I've got to talk to him.
No, you can't do that. You know what she's capable of.
She can't hurt me, not while she needs me.
06.
Bye, sweetie. I love you. Bye, Sherry. I'll see you tomorrow. Thanks again for watching her, Jane. Chuck Bosnell, my name is Ellen Bradford. I work with Deidre. I need to talk to you.
You stay right there.
Do you know where Deidre's going tonight?
Yeah, Chicago. I'm going with her.
You are?
She's going to a stockholders meeting to meet some clients. Then we're going to my brother's. Well, what the hell is this all about?
Your daughter has no clients.
What do you say?
Mr. Bosnell, your daughter is not a broker, she's a secretary. And she's trying to force me to steal millions of dollars of the firm's money. I'd bet anything that she's planning to leave the country and to bring you with her.
That's a good one. Oh, they'll miss me. My daughter has worked too hard to get where she is. Why would she need to steal a dime when she's about to make a huge commission on a company she discovered?
Which one?
Rickenheim, it's an earth-moving manufacturing company. They're gonna merge with some company in Taiwan.
Rickenheim, I found that company. That's my recommendation. Deidre found that information in my report.
I don't have to listen to this.
Check it out. You don't know your daughter as well as you think. She murdered someone, and she's planning to frame me for it unless I cooperate.
You're crazy. Get out of here.
You're the only one who can stop this. You're the only person she's afraid of.
You're talking about my daughter. I raised her. I lived with her. There's not a bad bone in her body, and I won't stand to hear of it. Now you get out of here.
How did you get in that wheelchair?
That's none of your damn business.
Do you know why the company thinks Deidre's going to Chicago? She told them her grandmother was sick.
You're lying. You're lying.
I am not lying. Please.
Get out!
And you taught her well. Because she's a criminal, just like her father.
I'm taking Cindy to see her mom. She has a surprise for her.
Are you coming back?
Yes. We'll be back.
Bye, Sherry. See you later. Are we going to Mommy's office?
No, I told you. Mommy's got a surprise for you.
What is it? And where are we going?
We're going someplace very special, someplace where your mommy's gonna meet us later.
Hi, Marcia. It's Ellen calling you back again. They said you hadn't come in today. Can you call me as soon as you get this message? Bye.
So, come on, let's sing.
Why are we going there?
I already told you. Now, come on. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy, I hate singing alone, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it, and you're happy and you know it, clap your hands.
Like to see you.
Would you call her mother and see if there's anything we can do?
Sure, okay. Les, what's going on?
It's Marcia. She was killed last night. They're saying that it was a hit and run.
Mary, have you seen Deidre?
No.
I can't believe what happened to Marcia. I know.
Hey, here we are. All right. Just like I told you, that's a big, beautiful house. Come on. Come on. Come on, sweetie. Come on. Oh, good girl. I want to go home.
You will, but first you have to be the very best girl in the world. You have to stay right here for now. Don't leave. If you leave, you're going to get lost, and your mommy will never find you again. And we don't want that to happen.
Huh? Why can't you stay here with me?
Because your mommy needs me.
Come on. Don't move.
Smile for the camera, sweetie. Good girl.
What are you doing here?
My flight got pushed, and I forgot a few things. Where's everyone going?
We're closing for the day. Marcia's dead.
She was killed last night. It was a hit and run.
That's horrible.
Trying to reach you. Good night.
Hello, Daddy. Is everything okay? Daddy. Daddy. She's been a problem here ever since she started working. Yeah. No. Daddy, Rickenheim is mine. She's crazy. Yes, the merger is gonna happen, Daddy. That's why we're going to Chicago for the shareholders meeting. Don't worry about it, Daddy. Just be ready at 9:30. The cab will be outside. Okay, bye.
everyone know where Ellen is?
Hello, I'd like to report a murder.
Go ahead. Hello? Hello?
What have you done?
She's perfectly safe, don't worry.
You kidnapped her?
I prefer to think of it as an insurance policy to keep Mommy in line.
Where is she?
She's playing hide and seek. I'd let you talk to her on the phone if there was a phone that worked, but there isn't, so you're just gonna have to trust me. Once you've done what I've asked, you'll see her. No police, no tricks, no surprises. So I think we should start. Could you log on the computer, please? Everybody's gone, all because of Marcia. How unfortunate.
Why would you?
Well, she was going to expose us. My father didn't believe a word you said, you know.
What do you want me to do?
Not one word. And you want to know why? Because you have no idea what we have together. You crossed the line, Ellen.
I guess this means we're not friends anymore.
$6 million from George Mathias's account into mine. Let's go. Punch in your password.
Where's my daughter?
She's right here. Punch it in. Today's access code. Start transferring. I thought you were so much smarter than this. You do want to see Cindy again, don't you?
Well, I have to say you really cooked up a scheme with this one. Everyone thinks Ted killed himself.
Ted was a pig. He used me. There's no place in the world for scum like that.
You got us to his house, didn't you? Set the fire. It was very smart.
I am very smart. You should have seen the look on his face when I pulled. He deserved it, Ellen. So did Marcia. You know, never understood why she didn't like me.
So what happens next? You're not really going to Chicago with your father, are you?
The only thing that my father ever dreams about is being able to live in a country where he can practice his trade. That's the least I could do for him.
Like you put him in the wheelchair?
Shut up!
There it is. Good work, Ellen. See, you were right. All I had to do was speak up. And look what it's done for my career.
I want Cindy.
Soon. We still have to get to the airport. You'll see her when I'm safely out of the country. Ellen, you don't have a choice.
Deirdre?
She attacked me, Daddy. She tried to steal money.
You lied to me.
I never lied.
I looked up Brickenheim. They're based in Dallas, not Chicago. Why did you lie to me? You were never a broker.
That doesn't matter anymore, Daddy. I'm taking you to Manila, where you can trade in the Asian market. We're gonna be partners.
Manila?
She kidnapped my daughter.
Is that true?
She wanted to play at the cabin, Daddy. She's my friend.
Deirdre, I'm ashamed of you.
You're ashamed of me, Daddy. For the last 5 years, you have blamed me for what happened to you. And you know it was an accident. Everything I have done is to help you try and get your life back.
Deirdre, this isn't about my life.
Everything I was supposed to do. I played by the rules and what I get. You think I wanted to be in your business?
I took this job so that you would talk to me at the end of the day. And I stayed, Daddy. And everybody else left you, I stayed. And still, there was nothing I could do to please you.
Deirdre, I just wanted you to have a career for yourself.
You wanted me to have your career, Daddy. The one you destroyed. You wanted to be proud of me. That's why I planned all of this, to show you that I can do it. Except I did it my way, because I wanted to put you back on top, Daddy. And give you the life that you couldn't give me, and the life that you couldn't give Mom.
Miss, put that gun down.
You have to go to my father, Ellen. I thought we were friends.
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you.
All right, it's great.
Hey.
Hi, Mom.
Oh, there's
even fine
here.
Some
juice?
Sure.
Hot today, huh?
Yeah.
Is Peterson going to be at the meeting Tuesday morning?
You want to jump
Oh, great.
Well, I'm just finishing up the last couple designs at home today. Good. Yeah, I'll see you then.
How exciting.
So there's Mom, look at me.
That's great, sweetie.
Let me take you guys out for dinner tonight, can I?
You paying?